They call him the shark paparazzi, armed with nothing but a camera and some nerves of steel. Mike Muller dives into the depths of the ocean to capture images of sharks cage-free. Mike is in New Zealand for the semi-permanent festival and he joins us now. Good morning, Mike.
Good morning.
So, I mean, I think you're crazy. I would never go diving with sharks, especially great whites, without a cage. I mean, are you not scared of sharks? Do you not have fear?
I used to be petrified of sharks. I was deathly scared of them. I surf and I saw Jaws and it ruined sharks for me as a kid. I just, every time I was out there, I'd be like, I can feel it. They're going to get me this time. So now 14 years ago, I want to see a shark. I want to go photograph one. I want to go see one. And my wife got me a shark trip for my birthday and I went out and I remember it was like yesterday when I saw the first great white come out of the darkness, swam by me, we locked eyes. I was like, oh, I see you and you see me. And it changed my life forever.
So wait, you're saying that sharks don't have cold, dead eyes?
They don't. They have really actually very similar to humans. They have iris and color in there. And if you don't put in a certain light, they look like black charcoal. But when you get down there in the water and there's actually, I've been able to capture in some of my photographs, you actually can see the detail.
Wow. Your photographs are amazing, but it's not just sharks that you work with. Mm. You work with celebrities, you've shot blockbuster movie posters. What made you decide to go from humans and well-known beautiful humans to these creatures of the deep?
Honestly, I mean, it started with that fear, fascination. I mean, my plan was just to go photograph sharks on a trip, and I got this bug in me. I was shooting the Michael Phelps and all the Olympic swimmers for Speedo, and I wanted to bring lights underwater, and I was like, I want to light a shark like I do Iron Man or Avengers with edge lights and all that. So I invented the most powerful underwater strobe lights in the world. I got 4 patents on them. And then I went to the Galapagos with the IWC watch campaign. Went down there really naive, and I have 3 daughters, and I didn't know at the time, but we were killing 100 million sharks every year. Half the Great Barrier Reef in Australia is dead or bleached, the coral. There's a piece of plastic the size of Texas in between California and Hawaii, and I'm like, I don't think my daughters are gonna see some of these things. Mm. So I've sold billions of dollars in movie posters. I'm gonna focus my attention on sharks and try to raise awareness and try to help these animals. They're the top of a really fragile ecosystem. So our ocean's extremely fragile, and if you start taking out the top predator, it's like a domino effect.
So, I mean, it's amazing what you do, and you were just talking about the lights before. Do you go up to a shark and just turn the lights on?
No. No, they're strobe lights. So that was actually a big question. How are the sharks going to react to these strobe lights? I think they're like people. They like the attention. They're
hey.
Like, hey, put my right side's a little better. No, they weren't bothered by the lights at all. But it was definitely a game changer because they're 1,200 watts. So it really throws a lot of light. When you're lighting a shark as big as, 20 foot, 18 foot great white, you need a lot of light.
Yeah. Speaking of great whites, so you're swimming with them cage free. Mm-hmm. Is it dangerous?
It's extremely dangerous. I started in cages I've spent thousands of hours underwater with all different types, bull sharks and tiger sharks and great hammerheads, and worked my way up. And I met my mentor, Mornay Hardenberg, and eventually exited the cage. And I think, there's a couple handful of people on the planet that can do it. I don't advise anyone to ever get out of a cage. And we're doing it for really specific. I'm working with Stanford University. I started getting into VR, and I just created this massive VR series. And part of it is focusing on PTSD and anxiety with people. So, the phobias, are you scared of sharks?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I saw Jaws and then I was afraid of swimming in a pool by myself.
So the cool thing with VR is that you put these goggles on and it's the closest thing to joining me out of the cage and feeling like you're there that you're ever going to do. So it allows them in the lab to work with, people that have these issues.
When you're swimming with these great whites, do you have people watching? Because what happens if it just decides that it wants to use you as prey?
Yeah, well, they do. I mean, here's all the other sharks and here's great whites. All the other sharks, we have to like bait them with fish to get them to even come close to us because they don't like people. I mean, they swim the other way. Great whites are ambush predators. And there's 2 ways they approach us when we're out of the cage. They come sort of real curious and slow, or they come like a missile, 25 miles an hour straight up at us. And there's always 3 of us out of the cage so that we have each other's back so we can cover 360. But when we see one coming at us, we then have to turn and go head on straight at the shark. And the shark's so smart, it realizes you're not prey, because everything swims the other way, right?
Of course.
So the minute you start swimming towards it, they're so smart, they're like, wait, you're not prey, and I don't like this, and they bank off.
Wow.
But you got to be committed if they don't bank off, what you're going to do.
Just nothing, just get eaten.
No, you have to move really quickly and maybe give them a little tap on their side of their
gills. No way, that is amazing. Mind blown, thank you so much, Mike Muller.
Thank you.
Just a little tap,
Just a little love. You never want to hit a shark, but just a little, let them know that you're the boss.
You get the flippers going and then.
Well, actually my wife's the boss, but you know, when I'm out there, let them know that.
But if they get you.
You can't get, that's the thing, you can't make a mistake.
You can't get caught.
There is no, you can't get caught.
If they did, could you, nose or eyes or something, isn't that one?
No, so that's the big thing, you hit them on the nose, everyone says that, right?
Yeah.
Well, you hit a great white on the nose, and the next thing that happens is that you're going to have a big open mouth in front of you. Now, the side of their nose, side of their gills,
or their
eye,
or their eye.
But the minute you even touch them, they swim the other way, like 20 miles an hour.
Awesome.
Wow.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
You're a brave man.